dependent on them. You know, when in fact you create your own money, your own reality, and as long as you just need to know that, step up to the plate and start living like that, and it will become your experience. If you truly believe that I can do what I love to do in life as my work, no matter what, and the universe will take care of every one of my physical and spiritual needs,
yeah,
and that's your true belief within, with no doubt, it'll become a fact of living for you. It will happen.
Yeah, it
will. Just you gotta have that knowledge, absolute knowledge, you know, without a doubt that's the truth.
Right.
And then that'll become your truth. You know, it could be, you know, if your truth is that you can fly anywhere, anytime you want, and you fully believe that without a doubt, and knowing, or you can teleport yourself anywhere with your thoughts, which is something that definitely can happen. Alien cultures often do that. They know how to do that.
Absolutely.
Just by your thought. You don't need a machine. You think it.
Yeah.
You know, but we can do it here. If you knew that absolutely without a fact, you would teleport yourself. You wouldn't need a car or anything.
Yeah.
Or a plane. You'd just be like, I need to go to L.A. And then there you are in L.A. You disappear.
Yeah.
That's how you can even do that.
Yeah.
And more. A hell of a lot more.
Subtract your
doubt. That's what we're talking about.
Stop doubting yourself and your thoughts and your
stop thinking you're so worthless and so little and so unable to do anything. Stop thinking like that.
Yeah, you're humongous.
You're huge. You're everything.
Yeah.
You're the all. You're a God.
Yeah.
You know, and gods can do anything.
What is it? I heard a quote from another song, you know, God is a DJ and life is a dance floor, you know.
That's right.
So, you know, what I mean by that, it's just like, you know, this is your opportunity to show off, you know. This universe, you know, this is your time to shine.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
It is your time to shine. Shine by showing other people the path. Teach them. Good way for you to get there is to show other people the path. We teach, and then every bit we teach, we advance more. It helps us to teach you up. You know, that's one of our paths that we work on.
Absolutely.
We teach, and then by virtue of teaching others, we start to experience more.
Right.
And, you know, we want you to be happy. We don't want you to be a slave to work and money anymore. It's time to get past that.
You know, take your talents and use them, you know.
Look at your natural talents.
Yeah.
Stop thinking, stop throwing them away. Like, you know, like, let me give you an example. Like, artistic people who can draw.
Yeah.
I know so many of them who are such great artists, but they throw it away because they say, well, I can't make money off of it. I've got to go work at Burger King, cooking French fries. I've got to work to pass stocking shelves at the grocery store or Walmart because I got to pay the bills. And draw and won't pay the bills. But you love to draw. Okay, let's say you're great at it. You love it. Why the fuck aren't you doing it
then? Yeah. Like, why is it that?
You know, are you scared that you're going to be evicted from your apartment if you start drawing and doing that?
Yeah.
And are you scared you're going to lose your possessions? It doesn't matter. You got to get past that fear. Sit down and draw. If you love drawing, draw. And then show it to people. Spread the word. Put yourself online. Show it to people. Before you know it, the universe is going to take you places. If you have that faith and knowledge, you'll be taking places.
You're not good at something for no reason.
No reason at all.
You know, given a gift. You know, like I feel like all I can do is play guitar and be a spiritual teacher, you know.
That's what I feel like. I'm not a musician, but I feel I can write music and words, and I'm a writer. That's my natural talent is words and writing and spiritual teaching. And my main talent is being able to understand spiritual truths.
Now, if I was rushing out and trying to be something else, like a school teacher or a lawyer, I wouldn't be good at those things.
Me neither. I could never do that because it's not meant for me to be.
Yeah, it's not my destiny. It's not what I want to do, you know.
No, if you know it makes you destiny.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, if it's what you want to do, that's cool, you know.
But to make money with it, like,
just to have a job,
pointless. And it would never work out. You might make some money, but you'd be there hating every minute of it. I can tell you that. You would hate every minute of it.
Yeah, I can see this. It's just all about, you know, certain things. For some people, it's just about making money. You know, like I said, if that's your dream, though, you know, follow it. Yeah, but I'm just saying, you know, for me, it wouldn't be all I'm good at. Like I said, is playing the guitar, singing, you know, songs about stuff. And
And he's a good medium, and a good psychic too, and a great spiritual teacher.
Yeah, both of us are. Yeah, we try to do the best of what we can do. So I try to play music on here, put some songs up. I hope to be recognized for both, you know, in my life. But that's all I think, you know, and I feel like, well, oh well, if I can't, you know, like if one day I decided that, you know, I wanted to just take on a regular job, I'd be forcing myself to go against my will, you know, making myself to do this.
I've tried that before. I tried to do a regular job and this, and it just never worked. I despised it. I could not stand it. It was destroying me.
It's like putting a cat in water, you know?
Yeah. I was going crazy just sitting there and just working 9 to 5 in the office. I was making like $15 an hour, which sucks anyway. That's not shit. A lot of y'all, maybe it is a lot of money, you think, but it's not really. But I hated it. I despised it. I had good at 9 to 5 at my own office, my own desk, and my own connection with the internet. I did what I wanted when I wanted to, but I hated it. I despised every minute.
Yeah.
And I just couldn't wait to get home so I could start writing spiritual stuff and taking care of that. That's what I wanted to do. And I quit that job. I said, what the hell is this? And the universe took me in the right direction. I was, you know, I could not do that anymore because it wasn't right.
Yeah.
It was destroying my mind, actually. I felt like I was being destroyed by doing that. I felt sick at heart.
Yeah, I feel bad for people that feel like they have to work. I mean, I know that sometimes people need money, and that's the way to go, you know, to make money fast, I guess, you know, just get a job.
Work or hustle, like that's another thing. A lot of people, like, that's another thing. Not only do people work, a lot of people think that they've got to sell drugs, or they've got to be some kind of hustler. There's different kinds of hustles, yes.
All types, you know. But,
you know, but you don't have to be no hustler. You don't have to be a thug. You don't have to be some drug dealer. Yeah. You don't have to do any of that. You don't have to work at some restaurant trying to get by, or stocking shelves, or in an office. You don't have to do any of that.
No.
Let me assure you.
You know, you might want to.
You might want to, thinking that you need to do it,
yeah.
But you're lacking faith if you're thinking like that.
Yeah.
If we have faith.
That's what's wrong with the majority of things that are going on now with people, is they're lacking faith 100%.
In the universe.
Sometimes you just gotta, like, go balls to the wall.
Yeah.
Jump off that edge, you know, as far as...
I wrote that last night in a comment. Don't be afraid to jump off the edge of the nest like a baby bird does.
Right, exactly.
To test your wings, just jump it off and trust that you're going to be able to fly. You're going to have to jump sometime.
Yeah.
And just jump. That's why I like Mike Bazin so much, his show at 3 to 7 o'clock on 105.7. And Mike Bazin used to be a subway operator in Chicago for all his life. And he got sick of it, and he said, I'm taking my chance. I'm going to just go balls to the wall and quit in my job. I'm going to be a writer and write my first book, and I want to be on the radio. And it came true. He went balls to the wall. And he said he was scared to death doing it the first time, quitting his job after 20 years or whatever. But it came true. I mean, I really respect Mike Bazin for that. That's a person I like to talk to. But we're going to go ahead. We got 2 minutes. I have a couple more things I can say. You know, I'm going to make sure it doesn't go over 20 this time.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Mike Bazin, I really recommend it. If you don't listen to his show on 105.7 here in Richmond or wherever it is in your city, listen to it. It's on that. And then the guy teaches a lot of spiritual truths and kicks some knowledge out. And, Mike, I got to say I respect you for that, brother. One day we'll meet you. This is something we see coming psychically. We'll be on your show one day, me and Jeremy. We're looking forward to that. Mm-hmm. We've seen it before psychically, reading ourselves and other people reading us. Anyway, we're going to call this one here for now. We'll be right back with the next one. Peace.